Hey, what's up, fellow creators? Scott here, ready to unleash some serious wizardry in today's tutorial. We are about to crack the code on a game-changing technique, unlocking the render resolution limitation in Nuke Non-Commercial like a Total Pro hack. It's time to smash those resolution barriers and diving deep into the heart of this powerful software to push boundaries. So whether you are Season Pro hungry for new tricks or a newcomer eager to level up, this tutorial is your golden ticket. So get relaxed, grab a coffee or a cup of tea, and let's roll the intro! Before we dive into the heart of this video, ask yourself, do you ever dream of crafting 3D cinematic sci-fi worlds? Well, buckle up because I've got something extraordinary for you. Welcome to an unexpected odyssey, episode 1, environment modeling with Maya. This full course is your gateway to mastering the art of modeling and designing immersive environments. I will be sharing with you how to plan and organize personal projects, keep motivation, and be efficient in tackling such a large environment scene. Discover a seamless modeling workflow that thrives on precision, channeling attention towards shapes, forms, and harmonious proportions. Uncover ingenious kitbashing and modular asset strategies that infuse life into your scenes. Let's turn your dreams into stunning reality. The adventure begins now, and you can join the journey over at primalvfx.com. You're likely familiar with the frustration of Nuke Non-Commercial's render output limitation to full HD format only. But what if you need to export in 4K, 8K, or beyond? That's where this pro hack comes in. This workflow ingeniously allows you to output any size format you desire. The core concept revolves around dividing your image into multiple tiles. Much like a puzzle, an image divided by pieces that we'll be assembling together later on. So we want to split the image into different pieces. Each piece will have a lower or equal format to full HD output. So if we take for example our final composite, the final size is a 8K with a 2.1 ratio. So it's 7680 by 3840 pixels. If we divide it into cells of 1920 by 1080, which is the limitation size output, we've got 12 cells distributed in 4 columns and 3 rows. And to complete the frame size, we've got 4 cells in a row with a resolution of 1920 by 600. This is the main idea behind this pro hack. Now let's jump back to Nuke. Let's see how we could set up it with ease. First off, let's focus on the first row. Let's put a transform node for shifting the Y value. For the first row, we don't need it, but let's put it. It will serve as a template for the next rows. We then have to create 4 different branches for each column. So the first column, create a transform node for shifting the X value. For the first column, we don't need it, but let's put it. It will serve as a template for the next columns. Then create a reformat node. Click on it to open its properties. In output format, click on the drop-down list and click on new. Put a name. Let's put output limit. And enter for the file size 1920 by 1080. Okay, so we created our first cell. Let's create a write node. Click on it to open its properties. Configure the file out path and let's call this cell A1. Remember to configure the color space to output sRGB because we are in an ASIS workflow. So for the second row, copy the 3 nodes like this and plug them to the top transform node. Let's change the value of the transform node, the one which controls the X value. In translate X, put a -1920 value. Now the write node, change the output name file to A2. So for the third column, copy the last 3 nodes again and plug it to the top transform node. Let's change the value of the transform node to -3840. Now the write node, change the output name file to A3. So for the fourth column, copy the last 3 nodes again. Change the value of the transform node to -5760 and write node to A4. Done. We made the first row.
So now for the second row, copy the last entire branch and plug it like this. Let's change the value of the main transform node, the one which controls the Y value. Let's transform Y, put a minus 1080 value. Then change the output file name to B1, B2, B3 and B4. For the third row, copy the last entire branch again. Let's change the value of the main transform node again. This time in translate Y, put a minus 2160 value. Then change the output file names to C1, C2, C3 and C4. Last but not least, the fourth row. Repeat the same process. Let's change the value of the main transform node again. This time in translate Y, put a minus 3240 value. However, we also have to change the reformat node. Remember the last row have a 1920 by 600 format. So click the node and in output format, click on the drop-down list and click on new. Put a name, let's put output limit 2 and enter for the file size 1920 by 600. Change the other ones for this row. Then change the output file names to D1, D2, D3 and D4. Done. Yeah, I know, it can seem tedious, but keep in mind that you can and will reuse this block of nodes many times for your future projects. Okay, so after setup the entire multi-output module of our comp, we have to render all the right nodes. We could click on each right node and hit render, but it will be really painful, right? So let me show you a quicker and clever way to do it. So select all the right nodes, like this. Go to the top menu, render, render selected right nodes. Hit the OK button. Done. One click to render all right nodes. Isn't that great? After exporting all your tiles from Nuke, we want to re-stitch them together like a puzzle. So after firing up Adobe Photoshop, create a new document and enter the size of the final frame. Open your folder containing all the tiles and just drag and drop them into Photoshop. Click Enter several times. Now you have just to reorder them in the canvas like a puzzle. Quite funny to do actually. What do you think, guys? Wasn't this technique a super interesting and effective method to unlock Nuke NC render resolution limitation? Let me know in the comment section.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.